Richards and running back James Barrett. Coach, it's great to see you back and talking about going to the ball walk today. You, actually, you're the guy who started the ball walk.
That's correct. Captain had one to go to the football complex. And some of our people were not for him. In fact, we didn't get to go to the football field. I knew what our opponents were doing. They were ahead of us. We were big but old, so we kind of got that done. We did the dormitory, did the new locker room for the home games, and put a lot of hustling and plotting to get it done. But we stopped staying at hotels in town. We would stay out in West Knoxville all day and back forth game. And we would pick up a pregame meal, take the buses in, and come to the stadium. And then we sat up there. Living in a dormitory, getting tough pattern security, and eating at the final table at Gibbs Hall, and also staying there, and then having our meetings in our new complex. And the health director at the time says, well, look at a bus, look at the bus take you from that campus to the stadium. I said, you know, I don't think it would be a good idea to walk down with the players so the fans can see the players in street clothes and the players can see the stands. I knew the Tennessee fans would be responsive. And that health director was very encouraging. In fact, he said, I'm not sure that would be a good idea. He said, what if your things aren't going well? I said, I'll take my chances. I'm more of an optimist than a pessimist. I'm pretty realistic, I think. And it worked out good. It started off with a bang. The fans were there. The players loved it. And walked all the way down the field. And this throng, there was a throng there, but the throng there is capitalized, triple capitalized by the people there today. It was something else. And to walk with my wonderful friend and former player James Berry and his great son Eric. I haven't seen James. I don't know anybody that I spent more time recruiting individually. I didn't do it by myself. Bobby Franklin was here. And I spent more time individually than I did with James Berry and Tony Dorsett. It limited the visits with James Berry. But I recruited Natchez when I was at Mississippi State. I had Mississippi River, Vicksburg, Natchez, etc. And I knew a lot of people at Natchez. And I gave him a good summer job. And I got met his mother. She was wonderful. That's where it all started. His mother was tremendous. She was smart, and she was good, and she could tell that she was telling the truth and sincere. We got to be great friends too, and now it's just the second generation, and we have hopes of more barriers to come back. I told James to put them on hold. When I make my comeback, I'd like to try to 50 yards.
And James was really one of your first big recruits in Tennessee since you came back.
77, I told you, it was 77 I came here. I did just at Pittsburgh. I probably spent more time talking to groups and they weren't going to come and talk, meeting coaches, etc. And I still had to do some time to Pittsburgh. I had some time to talk, so I committed to. And I had to spend some time on trying to get the facilities better, etc. And Lane Kiddings off the better start than we were. We struggled 2 or 3 years because I had to spend a lot of time on trying to talk to people to get better facilities and improve our network here and whatever. And our first year recruiting was pretty average. The second year we signed 7 or 8 Marine All-Americans. 4 of them were backs, including this young man who became an outstanding player of ours, and Terry Daniels, and Glenn Ford. Ford dropped out after the second or third year. He and Daniels stuck together. Great job for us. They made me look better as a coach. But we go back, and I'm so proud of James and what his leaders wife and accomplished with these outstanding sons.
James, talk about coming down the ball walk today with your son, Eric Berry, who's just not only a great player, great student athlete, and a great representative of this university.
Well, first of all, I just like to say this is a real pleasure to be here. And then trying to keep up with Coach Davis coming down the ball walk, that's probably the hardest thing I've done in the last 5 years. But actually walking down, coming down with Davis today, it did my heart proud. And to see the response of all the big arms fans and everything, you know, I know that he loved it, I love it, you know, it's just a pleasure to come back to Tennessee and see that we still have the best support of all.